the other person will understand. And let me tell you something, it's very difficult for a man or a woman to guess all the time what the other person is thinking. Would you agree with that? Right? It's tough. You know, no matter how much you may be tuned to the other person, you can never actually guess what is going on in the other person's mind. Otherwise, if this were not true, we wouldn't be having a divorce of a 98-year-old man divorcing a 94-year-old woman. It means there is some difference in opinion still, you know, like still to be bridged. It didn't happen in our country, but then in any part of the world, this is something very, very bad, that at the age of 98 and 94 they are divorcing. Yes, after so many years, right? So what happens is criticism, to cut the long story short, criticism should be positive, and when you criticize somebody, you should always provide a solution for something. If you are not doing this, you are not doing, don't say like, I don't like the way you do it, please do this for me. You should give a solution, whether it's a man who's criticizing or the wife who's criticizing. So always give solutions, what you want. Touching, especially when things are difficult. Touching is something which is very, very important for a woman, right? Sometimes what happens when there has been a fight, the man keeps on fighting with her and probably leaves the place. But then probably if a man actually touches her, you know, on her shoulder, or maybe, you know, like just touches her, that gives her a lot of emotional comfort. So it's very important that the man understand the importance of touch, especially when it is so important for a woman. Planning and having fun. This is very, very important, that in your life you have to plan to be together, you have to plan your leisure, you have to plan your holidays, and you have to make sure that in your hectic schedule you introduce some kind of fun and pleasure in your activity. It's very, very important. Next would be being adaptable to change at roughly the same rate. So you have to understand that when you began your life as newly wedded couple, it was very different, because then you had no responsibilities. It was basically a lot of praise and less of blame. And then initially when you get to know each other better, it's actually the praise becomes less and the blame becomes more. And then you are saddled with the responsibility of bringing up children. Till finally at a point when the children are grown up, and again you are left on your own to be each other's lifelong companions. So both of them should be moving at the same rate. To give you an example, in earlier times we had these film stars whose wives were, you know, looked very different from the husbands. The husbands used to make a lot of progress, and the wives would be just, you know, like housewives. And then they would say that we've grown apart, and they used to divorce. But now look at Gauri Khan and Shah Rukh Khan. Even Gauri Khan has her own life, she has her own identity, and she is almost, if not equally good, but at least she has her own place in society, where both of them are developing, growing, emotionally and in every other way. So it's very important that both the man and the woman grow together. This is a very Western concept, it sounds like that. We've never realized the importance for both the man and the woman to grow. It's only, you come to know about these things when you find out somebody who's at a mental level as you, and then you realize, oh my God, what kind of partner do I have in my own house? So it's important that you pick up activities which both of you jointly enjoy, and there should be emotional growth in a partnership, otherwise it becomes very stagnant and done. The next would be solving problems as they occur. See, when we try to push problems under a carpet, what happens is we think, you know, after some time everything will be forgotten. But as we all know, a woman never forgets. Would you all agree with that? Yeah? It's yes. And it's not that a woman is bad because she cannot forget, it's just that her brain is made that way. Fine? It's just that her brain is made that way. We cannot blame her for that. That she would remember very little things, and then probably at a time of a fight, she would bring back the whole thing and would like to, yes, yes, yes. And there is no end to it. Right? There is no end to it. So it's very important that one of the ways in which you can solve your problems is something like this, which I normally, couples whom I counsel, what I normally tell them, you know, there would be different areas. Like, you know, for example, if she wants to talk, let's say he or she wants to talk about finance, then make a symbol of F. Let's say she wants to talk about social life, and then the symbol would be this. She wants to talk about love, then you know, a symbol like this. Or probably, you know, she wants to she has a problem related to sex, then you know, we could have a symbol something like this. And then you have different categories in which you could have a problem, and then for every category, for example, financial problem, let's say the husband has a financial problem with the way the wife handles the money, and then he could give a rating between 1 to 10. There's a whole sheet which I have not brought it today, but let's say the husband has a problem about the way the wife uses money, and the degree of problem is, let's say, somewhere around 5. Let's again take the case of social life, where the husband is probably overworked and is not spending enough time with the wife, and the wife says that she has a problem with the husband's social life, and her degree of problem is, let's say, 6. Again, so on for, let's say, for the love life, the wife has a problem which she would rate as 7, and the husband has a problem with the wife's sex life or whatever, and let's say it is 6. In that case, a table is made where if something is labeled as 10, you need to start discussing the problem within 24 hours. You cannot expect that, you know, I have a problem and solve it to me right now. That's not possible always. But you have to select a time, let's say within 24 hours they have to begin their discussion. And then suppose the rating is, let's say, 6, then you can give some more time to yourself, that is 36 hours. And that way, at the end of the week, you should be in a position to at least begin discussing the problems and come to some kind of solution. Because if you don't solve a single problem, it keeps on piling up, and then ultimately it cannot be solved. Right? So you have to set aside a timer like that and leave aside everything, and you have to solve your problem. Respecting the other's family. It's very important that we respect the other person's family, of course keeping certain limitations in mind. If somebody's, if your partner's immediate family members are very abusive, you have every right to talk to your husband or your wife about it. But then having said that, a relationship like marriage expects that you respect your partner's family. And most of the men and women actually do, at least in our society they do, whether they like it or not, but at least they apparently show that they respect. Right? Of course, in Western countries, they are not living together, so it's a different issue altogether. But we normally do that. Being forgiving. How many of us can easily forgive if somebody has hurt us? But it's very easy to say, but how many of you can really and readily do it on a daily basis? You can do it. What about you? Can you easily forgive? You can. Okay, very good. Okay, now you can. Okay. Okay, what about you? Can you easily forgive people? You need some time. See, I'll tell you something. Forgiving is something which doesn't come very easily and readily to us. Because if you're very close to somebody and somebody has really hurt you, you feel that, you know, somebody has let you down. But you have to understand, and then you have to view your partner in a very objective light, thinking that he or she is also a human being, apart from the fact that he or she is your partner, which we fail to do. We assume that just because he or she is your wife, they're expected to behave exactly in the way you want them to behave. But that's not always possible. You have to give them that chance to fail, and then help them to, you know, like bring them back. Okay, and the last one would be learning to enjoy domestic life. See, this is very important, because once we grow old, when we are probably in our 70s and 80s, there'll be very little outing, right? Because of your physical incapability, most of the time you'll be locked into your own house. So if you've never liked to live inside your own home, probably that's the time when you will not enjoy doing it anymore. So you will need to spend some time in your own home where you can relax and feel as comfortable probably when you're going out and dining out somewhere. Okay, now this brings us an end to our 20 tips. If you have any questions related to sex and human relationships, you could ask me so that I'll try to see if I can answer them for you. Any questions if you have, either for yourself or for anybody you feel is in a kind of a relationship problem and what they can do about it. Think for 2-5 minutes.